For today's video, let's talk about a term that's been in the news recently related to polio vaccines, and that's known as vaccine-derived poliovirus. But as a quick reminder, there are two different types of polio vaccines. The first is IPV, or inactivated polio vaccine, that uses an inactivated form of the polio virus via an injection method. And the second is oral poliovirus, that uses a highly weakened form of the polio virus via an oral droplet method. And I'll link the video to this explanation in this video's description below. But for vaccine-derived poliovirus, we're only talking about OPV. Now, vaccine-derived poliovirus is very rare, but it's common in areas where there's low vaccine coverage. And the way that it happens is when an infant is vaccinated with OPV, this allows for that highly weakened form of poliovirus to begin replicating in their gut. And that's what causes antibody production to occur, allowing that infant to be protected from a future poliovirus infection. But when that infant excretes waste, it still includes a highly weakened form of the poliovirus. And on rare occurrences, that weakened form can have some mutations, allowing it to be a little bit stronger. When entering wastewater in areas where there's poor sanitation, that virus that's now a little bit stronger could come in contact with an unvaccinated individual. And that could be an unvaccinated infant, or it could even be an unvaccinated adult. And it could also be somebody who is immunocompromised, who doesn't have protection against poliovirus, leading to them now becoming infected with that stronger form of the original weakened form of OPV, leading to vaccine-derived poliovirus. So how do we reduce this very rare occurrence? Well, that's with increased vaccination rates of poliovirus, and that can be through either IPV or OPV. Now, it's important to remember that in the United States, only IPV has been used since the year 2000. Also, we can have increased clean water and hygiene in areas where we know that there's this low vaccine coverage. So make sure to stay connected with my channel and with Dane Garvin for the latest health-related news.